So, hello everyone, it's me, Harshit from SCITECHE. This is the first video of the complete PictoBlox series. In this series, I'll guide you step by step, starting from the very basics of block-based programming in PictoBlox to advanced level coding, AI, ML and robotics using the same software, PictoBlox. Today in part 1, I'll give you a complete overview of the PictoBlox software and show you how to use it. For more details, you can check the video chapters. Without wasting any more time, let's jump to the computer screen.
I'm here on my computer screen, as you can see, and here's the PictoBlox, and which is just like similar to Scratch 3. So we will be going to compare and differentiate between both of them. So let me open Scratch 3 first. So that's the Scratch 3 environment where we get like different block palettes. So you get a total of 9 different block palettes with like multiple blocks inside them. Then this is again the same scripting or coding area. This is the stage area, and this is the area from which, from where you can adjust the properties of a stage or maybe the characters. And then we have like a full screen mode and like code, costumes and sounds, and then few of the extensions over there. Okay, so that's like very, you can call them as like 3 row of yampest. You will be going to get extensions only. So this is the Scratch 3, where you can do different things like creating animations and creating games only. Okay, now if I open PictoBlox now, so you will see like there are a lot of different features you will be going to get instead of only block-based programming inside PictoBlox. So I know even PictoBlox does have that Scratch 3 kind of interface, which is only one of the features. So this one feature only contains the entire Scratch 3, you can say, with advanced part of Scratch 3. So we do have junior blocks, which you can take it as like simplest level of junior block-based coding, then block-based coding, and then we have Python and Python notebook options as well available over there. We have machine learning options available there. We have 3D options available there. So in Scratch, we don't have AI, ML, and Python, which is actual programming and 3D programming, but here in PictoBlox, we does have all that. But even if we compare only this interface, which is similar to that of Scratch, so if I open that in like a split window with Scratch, you can see like it is like exactly same like a block-based coding area. The only difference is with like color. You can say like this is blue and this is purple. But here, if you look, we do have Python, which is not available over there. And here, we do have firmware, which is not, which is for sure, which is required only for the robotics part. So you can't integrate Scratch with robotics, but you can integrate your PictoBlox with robotics. Second is we do have 2 different modes for robotics part again, the stage and upload one, which we don't have there in like a Scratch. So we can't integrate, you can say like this Scratch with robotics part. Okay. So if we come back again over there, so if we go to board, we do have a wide range of board supports available inside PictoBlox, but there is not even a single option on board. So these are a few things which are different over there. And last thing is basically the extension option. So an extension inside PictoBlox, you will be going to get like a lot of different extensions, which includes like machine learning part as well. But in like Scratch, it's very limited and like very, very less amount of extensions you will be going to get. So it's not there in like Scratch to work, it's not available to work over like machine learning part using the Scratch, but you can do each and everything relating to machine learning, AI, ML, 3D and all other stuffs inside PictoBlox. So I hope the difference between both of these platforms are clear to you. So let's start with PictoBlox. So for those who have not installed PictoBlox yet, let me tell you like how you can install. So let's first start with the installation part. So you can directly visit any of the browser. So as you can see now, I have opened up my web browser and just search for download PictoBlox. Okay, so after you search download PictoBlox, you will get this website from the side of Stempedia. Just click over this link. I will attach the link in description as well, from where you can download PictoBlox. Okay. So the first feature of PictoBlox is basically it's platform independent, which means you can use it on almost each and every type of operating system. So on this link, you can see it's available for Windows, macOS, Linux, Chromebook, Android, iOS. And at last, we have a web version also available. I will tell you about this a little later. So you can use it on web version as well. Okay. So this is the Windows version. Here you can download the 8.1 version, which is as of now, which is beta version, 8.0.1. And maybe till the time you are watching the video, it may be a newer version. So you can download it accordingly. So you will get the latest version at very top, and you can select whichever your operating system is from there. Okay. So once you have downloaded this software, you can directly install it by just double clicking it and like clicking next and like providing it a few of the permissions, and then it will be installed into your system. So you can download the PictoBlox using this link. And the second thing is, as I told you, you can access it online. So you just need to visit this website, which is PictoBlox.ai. And once you visit this website, you will be able to access the same software in completely online mode. And you can access it again on any of the operating system. So there will be no problems with that. Okay. So as you can see, it's loading. So like it will take some time to load. But the only difference in the online version and in the online offline version is that in online version, as of now, you can't use machine learning environment and 3D XR environment, which is available in PictoBlox. So if you don't know about this environment, then there is no need to worry about. We will be going to look into them as well. Okay. So like till the time it is loading, let me go back to my main screen. And here's my PictoBlox, which is the main software which we will be going to use today. So let me just actually start with the introduction part of PictoBlox. Okay. So like I have double clicked to open the software PictoBlox. So PictoBlox is basically a block based coding software where you can create animations, create games, and can use it for stamp purpose, and can even program all of your robots without writing single line of code. So that's the overview interface, or like the getting started interface of PictoBlox, which comes in front of you when you open the software. So here in PictoBlox, we have an option of junior block space coding, and then normal block space coding, then Python option and Python notebook option as well. So it's not only limited to block based coding or scratch based coding. Here you can do Python or text based programming as well. So I can call it as like combination of like programming as well as which means textual programming and then block based programming both. So you can do no coding here and low coding here and textual coding. So all three types of coding you can do here. So let me tell you what are these three types of coding is. So first one is no coding, which is also known as block based coding or scratch based coding, where we use these type of blocks. And then second one is normally text based coding, which we generally used to do in Python, C++ and any other programming language. And there is third type of programming is which is known as low code, L-O-W, which means we have to write very minimum amount of code, because that's the combination of both block-based coding and then the normal textual coding. So what happens over there is like you will be going to do whatever you wish to do using the blocks. And if there is something limited over there, then for that specific purpose, you can write the code using the provided coding language available. Okay. So here we can work over all of the three types of coding. And then we have machine learning environment where we will be able to create our own custom machine learning models. So here we will be going to actually get two types of models, which is basically like pre-trained, and then second one is which we can train by ourselves. So you can get ready to use model which you can directly import in your projects and can start using them. And second one is like which you can train and then test and then improve the accuracy and then can use them. And at last, we have 3D and XR Studio, where we will be able to create our 3D designs as well. So we can use it for robotic simulation purpose, and we can create 3D animations, can like apply the logics of physics and create a whole 3D environment over there. So it is the combination, or like it includes augmented reality, virtual reality and extended reality. So we will be going to dive deep into what these technologies are. So like if I just describe PictoBlox in like a quick few lines, so I can say like it is block-based programming software where we can do block-based programming and can program our robots, can create animation and can create amazing games without writing single line of code. And it combines all of the 21st century skills, because it does provides whatever is in 21st century skills, you can say IoT, machine learning, AI. So each and everything you will be going to get here. And like, again, no code technology is there. So it's like a really time saving kind of thing. So that's a quick overview of this software, PictoBlox. One most important thing when you are installing PictoBlox, so like just during installation, you get this type of pop-up as well. So let me show you like what you have to do during like installing. So this type of pop-up in front of your screen. So this is the pop-up which you may get in front of your screen when you are installing. So this installation is required only when you are like going to deal with the robotics part as well using PictoBlox. So this is like a, you can call it as a driver file, which is required for ESP32 based microchipset, which you may be using with Quarky. And like if you are using Arduino, you know, then there is another driver. But if you missed over that time, then you can directly go to settings and from the device driver installation, you can use or install those driver if you missed that part. Because if you have not installed the drivers with PictoBlox software, you might not be able to work over the robotics part.
Okay, so in this first part of complete PictoBlox series, we have covered a quick overview and introduction of the software PictoBlox, compared it with Scratch 3 and its installation process including drivers. From the next part, we will be going to deep dive into each and every of its feature. If you have any question, doubt or suggestion, you can leave the same in the comment section below. And finally, thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe us. Thank you.